the Faculty Friday, or every Friday, we talk to some of the Mount's favorite professors. This week, we're joined by Dr. Beth Murray, professor of biology. And many of you might not know this, but Beth actually did her undergrad at the Mount. So let's start there. What was your favorite memory of your undergraduate days at the Mount?
I really loved the classes. I had a very diverse schedule. I started at the Mount as a single mom, because the Mount had a daycare center at the time. So if I would take any class, as long as it lined up, for example, like between 9 and 12 on Monday, Wednesday, Friday. So I took such diverse classes, and I had great professors, everything from art history to, you know, ancient history to the science courses that I loved. And that was very interesting for me. I changed my major 4 times during the time I was at the Mount because I kept getting sucked into interesting areas. But I think if I had to settle on really what was most important, it was the friendships I formed. And, you know, all these years later, I started at the Mount in 1980, and I still hang around with some of those people, which is very cool.
That's really telling of the strong bonds that you build here. Now, you mentioned some of your professors there. I think a lot of current students would say that maybe you're their favorite professor or one of them. But when you flip that around and think about your undergraduate studies, who was your favorite professor?
My favorite, and I'm not just saying this because he's my dean now, my favorite professor was Gene Kritzky. He came to the Mount in 1982 or 83 to reinvigorate the biology major, which had been shut down. Biology was a service program for other majors at the university, the college at the time. And when I met Gene Kritzky and sat in his classes with these same people that I hang around with now, in fact, Gene comes to the dinners when we have them, that's when I was hooked. That's when I knew that biology was what I was going to do. So he had not just my relationship with the Mount, but my relationship with the man, the myth, the legend, Gene Kritzky. It continues to this day. In fact, a little known fact is I was the best man at his wedding.
Wow.
Well, I like to call myself the best man, but there were really only 2 witnesses. His wife had her stepfather and Gene had me. But I do like to call myself his best man.
You never know what you're going to learn on Faculty Friday.
You never.
With your role in the School of Behavioral Natural Sciences, can you talk about everything that that encompasses?
Well, of course we teach. And as faculty members, especially in the sciences, we do research. My research is not traditional scientific research. It is, I write books for grades 7 to 12 about science, because that's one of the things that kind of hooked me on science at an early age. And I also do forensic work, which is a bridging of scholarship and the third pillar of being a faculty member, and that is service to the community. So I like to think that all of my 3 layers of teaching, scholarship, and service are all, you know, they're all part of my role in the Behavioral and Natural Sciences School.
And is there anything that you would like to specifically shine a light on within your work?
You know, I think most people know about the forensic work, but many people don't know that I have courses for the teaching company that are geared towards lifelong learners. I've, as I said, written science books for grades 7 to 12, and I love doing that because I think it's part of our responsibility as teachers, especially when you get a PhD and you're way out at this terminal end of, you know, knowledge, where, you know, they say an expert is somebody that knows more and more about less and less until eventually they know everything about nothing. But I like to think that as you get down that pathway and you specialize in an area of science, the ability to take a step back from that and be able to teach it at the undergraduate level, or to be able to teach it at the graduate level, and still be able to distill it down for everyday folks who are just interested in learning something more, or kids to inspire them in science. I think that is the most exciting thing that I find about teaching, to take this high-end knowledge and make it accessible to anybody at any level in some way that they find interesting.
Out of the ivory tower and down into the weeds among, you know, the everyday person. No, I think that's really an amazing thing and a thoughtful thing, and bravo to you on that. And I guess I'll end with this. You know, it's been an interesting 4 or 5 months now with the pandemic and everything going on. Have there been any interesting stories of things that have happened to you or things that you've done during that time?
Well, I've been teaching the whole time. And I have to say, I have learned to love this remote teaching in ways I never thought. It is disconcerting not to get to know the students as well, but especially for the graduate students, what's been inspirational to me is seeing how they're embracing this. It's not exactly what they wanted either, but we're making the best of it. And I think that's something the Mount has always done, is make the best of whatever we're handled. And I see that some of these students, especially the graduate students, I taught the PA students, our physician assistant students in the spring, and now I'm teaching full-time to the doctoral students in physical therapy, and seeing how they are actually doing very well in this environment, that's kind of been inspirational. So I think that was unexpected, to see that we can do this, we can do it well, we can engage them in ways that they are learning. And I'm seeing higher grades in some cases than I would before, because I've asked the students, and some will say, you know, when we're in class for 2 hours of lecture, we might get burned out, or we might tune out, or we only can get down as much as we get down in that time. But with the remote, when it's taped, it's available to them. Some of them, I see my clicks on YouTube, they'll watch 3 and 4 times each. And so they're able to recapitulate this information to themselves in a way they couldn't before. So I've been really impressed with that. And I'm impressed with our students. I'm impressed with our faculty for taking this challenge and running with it.
And I certainly applaud you as well for taking that extra step, doing those videos, but also doing this video here for Faculty Friday. So Dr. Murray, thanks so much for your time. You have a great one.
Thanks, you too. Good to talk to you. It's finally Friday.